welcome back to Tales Along El Camino Sierra.
We've been very busy lately working on our many Eastern Sierra history projects.
We've been working on putting together an audiobook of Tales Along El Camino Sierra 1.
And in addition to that, we've been gathering information, doing research, collecting photographs, because we're also starting work on the print version of Tales Along El Camino Sierra 3.
And we're hoping to have it out by summer of 2020.
And that's not very far away. A lot of our time's going to be spent working on this print book, so our YouTube schedule of once a month might have to be extended a little bit.
We're sure you'll understand it'll take us a little longer.
With that, we hope you enjoy this episode.
This tale of Eastern Sierra history is Mammoth Mountain Man Dave McCoy. Today, visitors to the Eastern Sierra travel on Highway 395 corridor the year round. In fact, according to numbers put out by the Mammoth Lakes Bureau of Tourism, the number of winter visitors to this mountain town is nearly equal to those that come in the summer. To be sure, due to its unique geographic location, Mammoth Mountain has been receiving the snowfall benefits of passing winter storms for tens of thousands of years. But it is thanks entirely to the efforts of one man that the Eastern Sierra has grown winter recreation to the level of sophistication that has made it one of the world's premier destination ski resorts. Dave McCoy spent his early years in Southern California before moving to Washington State after the eighth grade. It was while living in Washington that Dave met some folks of Norwegian ancestry and learned about skiing. He made his first set of skis in his high school woodshop class. Dave moved to Independence in the Eastern Sierra shortly after graduating from high school. It was here, while working at the restaurant known as Jim's Place, that he met his wife, Roma. They soon married and have now enjoyed over 7 decades of marital bliss. Skiing was quickly becoming popular in the U.S. at that time. Dave and a few friends constructed a simple rope tow that they could move to different locations along the Eastern Sierra. His primary location was just off Highway 395 on McGee Mountain, using parts from a Model A truck to operate a rope tow there. There is a highway marker on Crowley Lake Drive, which is also old Highway 395, that's been placed by the local E. Clampus Vitus chapter, marking the nearby location of McCoy's McGee Mountain Ski Hill. Dave got a job working as a hydrographer for the Los Angeles Department of Water and Power. His job was to travel on skis during the winter, measuring the snowpack at various backcountry locations throughout the Sierra Nevada mountains. Dave quickly became familiar with what areas harbored the deepest snows. Dave and his friends soon began operating their portable ski tow on the snow-trenched north slope of Mammoth Mountain. Shortly thereafter, the Forest Service posted a request for bids to develop a ski resort at Mammoth Mountain. Dave made a proposal, drawing up his business plan on a single sheet of paper. He drew 3 lines on it and called them chairlifts. The Forest Service was convinced and gave Dave a permit to build the first ski lifts at Mammoth Mountain. Dave was able to buy 4 surplus tracked military vehicles called Weasels to use at Mammoth Mountain. Some skiers would ride inside the vehicle while others would hold on to ropes coming off the back as Dave would take them over the snow to the rope tows. Everyone would be singing and laughing as they were taken along the snow to the slopes. This was the beginning of Mammoth Mountain Ski Area. Dave worked out a deal with United Tramway Company to purchase and install a chairlift. Many of the holes for the towers were dug by hand by Dave and his friends. The beginning of Mammoth Mountain was truly a grassroots effort. A ski lodge was built in 1953. According to Dave, people would come up and work for free because they loved Mammoth Mountain so much. He credits his employees and his customers for providing most of the good ideas that helped him develop the resort. Dave started the ski team at Mammoth Mountain in the 1960s, and he soon had 14 Olympic racers on his team. In 1965, visitors were expressing their desire for access to the top of the mountain so they could ski the best slopes. A chairlift to the top was not an option because the top was just too exposed to the elements. Dave worked out a deal with a Swiss company for the mountain's first gondola, opening thousands of acres of new terrain for skiing. In 1986, Dave bought nearby June Mountain and had plans to link it with Mammoth Mountain in the style of the grand European ski resorts. Alas, these plans were never able to materialize. Mammoth Mountain Ski Area continued to grow, and Dave kept reinvesting the profits to make improvements there. Dave's interest turned to helping the town of Mammoth grow right alongside with his ski area. He bought several parcels of land in town and practically gave them away to people that were willing to build hotels and restaurants. In addition to the ski area, Dave launched the town's first water district, along with the fire department and high school. In 1989, he founded the Mammoth Lakes Foundation, which helped fund Cerro Coso Community College. Over the years, the foundation has provided over 650 scholarships to students who otherwise may not have been able to attend. English poet William Blake once said, "Great things are done when men and mountains meet." Dave McCoy's life has melded well with his beloved Sierra Nevada mountains ever since his arrival in the 1930s. His positive influence on the lives of visitors and residents alike has become legendary. In a land of mammoth mountain landscapes, Dave McCoy has been a mammoth mountain of a man making the turns along El Camino Sierra.
Dave McCoy, a true mammoth of a mountain man.
You know, we recently had the honor of doing a personal slideshow history presentation for this giant of Eastern Sierra history. I'll tell you, it was a true highlight for us to be able to do so.
Please follow us on Facebook. We post a tale of Eastern Sierra history about twice a week.
And if you have an idea for a tale we should put together, or any other comment, like always, we'd love to hear from you. Please send us a message, a private message, an email, whatever. Let us know what you're thinking. Thanks again for tuning in, and we hope you always enjoy the tales you create from your own travels along El Camino Sierra.